So the Axis Bank board telling the Reserve Bank of India that Shikha Sharma has requested that her reappointment be reconsidered. Your first reaction, sir?
So my first reaction is very simple, that if there was an issue with performance of Axis Bank under leadership of Shikha Sharma, then the board itself should have taken note of it and not appointed her. Now, if the board has appointed her for 4 years and the Reserve Bank finds fault with it and then comes back to the bank and asks it to reconsider, the board reconsiders and they it is managed that Shikha Sharma herself requests that let me go after 6 months, then there speaks a volume in the sense that either the board was not correct in the first place or they did not evaluate it properly, or if they were 100% confident that Shikha Sharma is a good leader and there was nothing wrong, then they should have gone back to the regulator and said that please tell us what are the reasons and we'll satisfy you. So here, as it happens in many other places, that the board either has succumbed to pressure of RBI or the board was wrong in the first place itself. But anyway, for Shikha Sharma, either honorable exit, rather than messing up the whole thing, which she has voluntarily decided to go. But I would say, again, the question of transparency remains everywhere in our country, be it ICICI, be it here, or be it any other corporate, because the real reasons of somebody's departure or appointment are not known. It is only that whatever is convenient is put in public domain.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, as investors who have actually put money into, you know, the Axis Bank stock, you know, do people not have the right to know from the regulator what was their specific concern that has led to the regulator asking the Axis Bank board to reconsider? And as you pointed out, if the board supported her reappointment as, you know, recently as the 8th of December when it wrote to the Reserve Bank, what has made the board capitulate at this point in time? You know, these are answers that we don't have. And while it may put the matter to rest with Shikha Sharma's exit, it speaks poorly of governance, not just at the level of the Axis Bank board, but also at the end of the regulator.
See, I would again say, Shijin, that a couple of days back or about 20 days back, the RBI governor has claimed that he has no power, nothing. Now the RBI has demonstrated its power. Now, if something was wrong with Shikha Sharma or Axis Bank under the leadership of Shikha Sharma, and the demonetization issues happened way back in 2016, and so they could have taken action in entire 2017. What was the need for them to take action when the reappointment is coming? Because if you find somebody not correct, you can ask the person to go midway. So the issue is very clearly that it is a decision by convenience of all the parties concerned. And that is not a fair thing as far as the investors or depositors are concerned. Because if I, as a regulator, I find something wrong somewhere, I should step in there and then. Why wait for a year?
And the reappointment was cleared by the Axis Bank board in December. And we're now in April, you know, and the regulator has expressed its apprehension as late as the end of March. So what has changed? And we don't have the answer to that question.
I will tell you what has changed. The change has happened for the first time in the history of Reserve Bank. Reserve Bank came under scrutiny of public eye and they were criticized. And in order to ward off any criticism, they said, okay, let us act somehow. So to me, the Shikha Sharma becomes the first victim of regulators' activity rather than anything else. Because it's